everybody, and welcome back once again to Let's Play The Witcher 3. In the last session, we were running around Ard Skellig, completing some side quests, and, uncovering some undiscovered locations. Today, we're going to start the session off by returning to Gremist. We have done what he has asked of us. We have... we found the abandoned distillery and brewed some alcohol for him. We found a pimpernel, a flower, and we've also found Frithjof and convinced him to talk to Gremist. So everything has been done. All we need to do now is return. Now, he's a master alchemist, so I'm hoping that at some point after we finish this quest, we might be able to buy some stuff from him, because we do have some items that we can craft if we can just nab some key ingredients. So let's start the session off by talking to Gremist and seeing if indeed the questline shall be completed. Or he's got something else that he wants us to help him with. I mean, goodness gracious, do we have to do everything? And where is he? Probably inside this cave here. There we go. Some kind of a den. Sorry to roll in on here, but, I finished what you've asked.
Did everything you asked.
Phenomenal, my boy! So, Frithjof, shall we begin?
The sooner the better. We've a long night ahead of us.
The ritual is only for members of the Inner Circle. Thus, my dear apprentice, you must wait outside. Under no circumstances must you enter. We shall begin your tutelage come morn.
As you wish, master. Be a good little student.
As you wish, master.
We'll make someone out of you yet, Witcher. Now off with you. Shoot.
That's nice, isn't it? We help him with all those things and he shoos us out like we're... well... some unimportant little naive apprentice. When we are a veteran seasoned Witcher. Wait until the next day. Well, before we do any more waiting, actually, I think whilst we are in the vicinity, there is an undiscovered location not too far from here that I just want to check out, so we can use that as an excuse to pass some time. It looks to be in some kind of a ritual circle or something like that anyway. We'll see what it is. It's not too far away. Just another 71 paces or so. Here we go. Oh boy. The hell is that? It's not an earth elemental, is it? Oh god, it is. Well, this will certainly pass the time. Gee, what am I getting myself into here? I could do with finding a blacksmith, get rid of some of these weapons, or at least a stash that we can put some of these things away. So after we've finished here, I think Kaer Trolde is waiting. Got a whole heap of junk as well. Okay, so we need some oils. Yes, we need oil of the elementa variety. We need Quen. We need Yrden. We need Thunderbolt, and we need Enhanced Tawny Owl, and then we need to kick some ass! Oh! Oh! What was I saying? Oh my god, you foul beast! Hard. hope whatever you're guarding is worth it. Oh my god! Try and finish him off with a killer blow! Nowhere near. Oh. Not quite a day has passed, but it blooming feels like it. Guarded treasure. This better be worth it. Diamond dust, some heavy armor. I'm probably going to be over encumbered after all this. Where are we on now? 130. Right, this is a nice little place to rest. Some kind of a circle. Druid circle. We shall wait. We shall wait 24 hours in quiet, peaceful meditation. And then we shall return for our lessons. Right. Is that 12 hours or 24? It's 24, isn't it? Yeah, it's 24. Talk to Gremist about our reward, okay. Hop foot it over to Gremist. See if he's going to teach us anything useful. Oh no, wolves, really? Really? Come on. Come on, I'm one of your brothers, man. If only by name. Doing so well. Oh, now that I've lost my rhythm, man. Curse you. I'm gonna change my name, my nickname at least, White Wolf. Can't stand the damn things. Maybe White Rabbit. Something less vicious. Oh look, here comes the White Rabbit. Run for your lives! Gremist! Well, they're still alive. Although he looks to be a little bit tipsy.
We must have another. That's good stuff.
Aye, as the base from Mosh Gordon and spirit from Hail Hell. Good times, Fritjof. Good times. Finally, something other than damn potions and transmutations.
Guess the ritual's not over yet.
Geralt, I thought I told you to stay outside. Only druids of the inner circle.
Circle, Smirgle, let the boy have some fun. He's earned it.
Fine. Pour yourself some. Geralt, let the lessons begin.
Study hard, drink hard. That's what I like. Yeah. Let the hair down.
Hard and study hard. I like the idea.
Yeah. I call it stimulation and assimilation. First you stimulate, and then you assimilate. I shut down.
Not sure about that, but I'll certainly sit.
Let's start with ingesting toxins. Best approach. Practice makes perfect.
Mm-hmm. I've practiced a lot already. Good thing.
I'll make learning my secret method easier. Look, you take the potion like this, and gulp.
Who said old age is a burden?
Some time later. Oh, we got a little bit drunk. Okay. Ooh, what's all this stuff he's giving us? Can I come back for more lessons tomorrow, Gremist?
What do you want now? I taught you all I know.
I just want to trade first.
Got anything to sell?
I do, but it's expensive.
Lucky for you, I'm rolling in coin. Near enough. Right, but I'm here on official business here, because I need to be able to craft two items here, two helpings, two portions of Negredo, and I need Belize fruit for that. So do you sell Belize fruit, mister? I'm not bothered about your damn recipes. Or am I? Oh, I might be. How do I know if I've got these or not already? I reckon I haven't got any of them, to be honest with you. And hence hybrid oil? This is going to take me ages. This is going to take me ages. Right, okay. I definitely needed allspice for something, so I'll take all of them. I'll take them all. Belize fruit. You don't seem to have Belize fruit. What kind of an alchemist are you, man? What kind of an alchemist doesn't have Belize fruit? I mean, jeez Louise. Okay, so we're not going to craft what I was hoping to craft after all. Oh my god. Really? Maybe he lost them in some kind of drunken stupor. So we need two portions of this. We need another portion of white gull, which we can now craft. Could craft quite a few of these actually, so I'll get another one of them ready just in case. And we'll have to leave it at that for now. Bombs. Superior grape shot. We needed Negredo, but we also need hop umbels. So does he sell them? You sell hop umbels? No. Yes, you do. There you go. Hop umbels. I'll just take them off. Thank you. Okay. Just double checking he doesn't sell those blooming things, but he doesn't seem to. Anyway, there's a plethora of recipes here that I need to just double check, so bear with me. I'll be back in a second. Okay, so it looks like all the recipes that he had in his inventory, I could purchase them, and I've crafted some of the formulae. Most of them were superior and enhanced versions of what I already had. And crafted a hell of a lot of new stuff. So that's very, very useful indeed, including all of the superior Draconid oil, superior vampire oil, enhanced hybrid oil. So So it's good stuff, but there's still a lot outstanding. He's run out of ingredients, and I need some white gold now. I need tons of white gold. All of these superior potions require alchemical substances, and all of these alchemical substances require white gold. So I need a plethora of white gold, which means I need a plethora of bloody cherry cordial and mandrake cordial. So I'm gonna have to be on the lookout for that. Anyway, so we've done all we need to do in terms of purchasing from this chappie, whose name escapes me again. He's got such a weird name, I keep forgetting it. Gremist, there we go. So now all that's left for us to do is play Gwent. And I assume...
Gwent. Never play the game?
If your question is, would I be interested in playing you? The answer is simple. No.
Me no.
Afraid of losing? I understand.
Very well. Out with your deck. Win, and I'll give you my best card.
Ooh, I think we hit a nerve there. Okay, let's hope that we beat him. I assume we're still both recovering from our... from our little drinking session. Let's see who has their wits about them best. This is not a bad draw, although we do have a distinct lack of siege. Might swap you out. Okay, that'll do. And clear weather could be useful, but I'd rather have siege, to be quite honest. So, do you know what? We do have a spy and a decoy, so we might get some more cards in our deck, and we do have medic as well. So, I'll stick with these guys. He's playing Nilfgaardian. It's my turn to go first. Do the usual, the usual trade-off with all the spies to start the game. His leader card can play Torrential Rain, which isn't good, but we do have clear weather. Good job we didn't get rid of it then, isn't it? What do we want to do? Right, sorry about that. Had to sort something out. Anyhow, so what was I doing? I'm trying to contemplate what strategy to use here. Nilfgaardian, heavy in archer. Some 10-point archers he's got. I wonder if we should play Villain Trap of Myth already. Get rid of that spy, put it in the discard pile. Stop him from decoying it, but he might have a few medics there. I'll play these guys to start with. Okay, a bit of a tentative start. He's not decoying the spy. He's not playing anything majorly scary right now. Play one of these this round. Trying to save my siege for the next round. Okay. It's a bit of a bugger that, isn't it, when it happens, but oh well, what can you do? We could use that ourselves. Take a 14 points. In fact, I could use this now. Can't scorch these off because he's already got 14 points on the board, so just keep him playing his cards if we can. We have the card advantage right now. Save these for the next round, save the medic for the next round because I can play it twice with a decoy if necessary, which leaves us only with Villain Trettenmouth. But then that's going to make me vulnerable to Scorch with these two. Okay, I can play this and medic that back in the next round. He's passed, he's given up. Okay. That's fine. Can medic both of these out in the next round if necessary. Great card for winning. 4 points. I reckon he's left his big cards here. There's a medic. Play the spy back at me. Makes sense. So I can only play my medic once now. If I take the decoy and take this, which I'm going to do, because I've got two more spies in here, so take that back. Right, back at you. Scorch and Dandelion. Marvellous. Not marvellous. I'll use Siri now. Get my points up, force him to keep playing. Oh, he's got Geralt of Rivia. Very good. Very, very good. But is it good enough? Three cards. I don't want to use Clear Weather. Can't use Scorch. Gonna have to use Dandelion. Oh. I think we're in a bit of trouble here. I screwed this up. 8 points. 7 points. I think we're in a spot of trouble. That's fine. I can't use Scorch. Gonna have to use this. Can you Scorch? No, I can't. Ah! 16 points, right. Okay. He's got Torrential Rain, don't forget. That's gonna kill me. That is gonna kill me. That's 26 points down. Yeah. Can't do it. Hey, oh man. If he doesn't use it now, there's obviously a serious issue. He hasn't used his Torrential Rain. He should have beaten me.
You won. I believe you're ready to challenge Madman Lugos. I do wonder if he'll agree to play you for his catacan.
What did I get? After all these bloody formula stopped flashing up, what did I get? Okay, while I'm waiting for this to pass. yes, his leader ability was to pick a Torrential Rain card from his deck. Mysterious Elf. Yes! Sorry, bit excited there. So he can't have had a Torrential Rain in his deck at all, which is why I didn't play it. So it's not a glitch, he just didn't have a Torrential. So why pick that leader card then? If you haven't got a damn Torrential Rain in your deck, why? Unless he hasn't got another leader card, which... Is that him crying? Was that him crying there? Sorry, did I beat you? Hey, Mysterious L, finally! Finally, that'll do. I think I'm going to take out John Natalis here. I think I've got too many of these I mean, they're good and all because they can't be affected by negative effects, but they can also be affected by positive effects, so there sometimes can be a hindrance as well. So I'll take out one of them. I could probably even have thought to take out Vernon, to be fair. Got two 15 pointers, a 7 point medic, and now this. Do I need Vernon in there as well? Watering down our, well, not watering down, but you know, giving us, making us, well, I'll leave him in for now. Well. Not bad. Some new alchemical formulae, henceforth crafted into potions and oils. A new Gwent card, one that I've been looking for a long time. Bragging rights, of course, in the face of almost defeat. Got a little bit lucky there. And now we have more to do, don't we? Yes, we do, is the answer to that. Yes, we do. Okay, couple of undiscovered locations here. We could head out to them, but we did that in the last session. We got uncovered a few in the last session, and we've got things that we could really, really crack on with. So we're going to go across here to Kaer Trolde, because there's a couple of things to do. Oh, I've come to the wrong blooming side of it, haven't I? Sorry, came to the harbour, should have gone to the castle. First of all, we need to return a letter to the smith from what sounds like his mother, who I think we found dead. And looks like he's gone to bed for the night, so we shall meditate inside. It's not actually inside, is it? But by the brazier, bit of warmth on the old back. Right, who do we need to speak to? Hard times. To the smith. You? You? One of you.
So you're back. Was right, wasn't I?
I haven't played Gwent with this guy yet. You kidding? Okay. Let's change that then.
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
I'm sure we have. Seeing as we're playing Gwent today, we're going to be playing Crack and Crate very shortly. Might as well keep on. Right, let's change that. Oh, wrong button. Oh no. Oh no. This is not good. Oh. Why? Why do this to me? Why? I pressed the wrong button. Oh, damn it. I'm just going to blast through this round here. Blast through this game because we're struggling. We've got no decoys, no medics, no way of getting any extra cards other than winning this round. Got a biting frost, which is going to prove to be useless. Sorry. Oh man, this is going to suck. Oh, he's passed as well. He's passed. I need a spy on this draw. I need a spy on this draw. Ah, Vernon, not good enough. Right. What I propose to do is frost out the front line so he can't play any frontline fighters, and then just use all of these this round, 1, 2, and 3. That's a guaranteed 40 points, and then pass, leaving myself with Dandelion and the two sieges for the final round, and he should have to deplete quite a lot of his cards to beat 40 points, I think. In fact, I won't frost the front lines out now until right at the very end. But yeah, I'm just going to go completely and utterly heavy on the hero cards here. Of course, he's probably got the same hero cards, and therefore this might not be quite as good a tactic as I would have hoped. Uh-oh. If he has the other twin to that, that could be disastrous. What's his fall test? I think his fall test is the clear weather fall test. That's a clear weather. Not pick a clear weather card from your deck. Okay. Right, what do I want to do? Do I want to pass now and see how many cards he wastes? Do I want to... or go all out this round and completely put these down, use my ability, go all in, and maybe leave myself Dandelion till the very end? I don't know. I really don't know. He has to get 16 more points. That's probably going to take him maybe two cards, maybe five cards apiece. I'll have a clear weather and these. He'll have used them and therefore can't benefit from any other type bonds. Okay, I'm going to risk it. It's a bit of a risky one. So I've got a guarantee, well, not a guarantee, but I've got potentially 28 points here. Take me to 68. That might be enough. Well, this could be a bad mistake. I'm going to chance it. A battle horn would just be perfect for him now, wouldn't it? 30 points, another 10 points, 6 points there. And then 5 points, and then he's only got 4 cards left. He gets a card, of course, for winning, which is a hero card by the sounds of it. That's not good. This was a risk. This was a risk. This is not good, this is not good. This is probably, or should maybe have, I don't know. It all went wrong from the very start when I pressed the wrong button. Downhill from there. Very, very, very much downhill from there. We're struggling. We're struggling here. But if he's playing fog cards with two cards to go, how much power has he got left in him? Is the question. How much has he got left in the bag? He's clearing the weather. He's looking like he's desperate here. He's playing clear weather after putting down fog himself. Unless he's passing the turn over to me. I'm not going to use clear weather. Biting frost will serve no purpose other than, unless he's got a frontline fighter himself, which therefore could hinder him. Yeah, excellent. It does hinder him. Fall test ability. Let's hope he doesn't have the last card as a scorch. No. That's two close victories. Wow. Oof. The risk paid off. Stefan Skellen. No idea who he is. Right, why can't I speak to... Who do I need to speak to here? I need to speak to somebody. To the smith. Deliver the letter to the smith.
So you're back. Was right, wasn't I?
Craft, master quality. What do you have in stock? Well, while I'm here...
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock.
Let's have a look at getting rid of some stuff, shall we? Okay, so what's this? Blood sword. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Ooh, Mahakaman heavy. Banal breastplate. Hunting boots. These are all rubbish. Rubbish. Right, these are the ones I'm keeping, I think, possibly. Okay, lovely. And if you wouldn't mind awfully repairing my gear. Okay. So it's not him.
So long.
There is a blacksmith over here that I can't talk to. Let's just try advancing here. Ah, now we can talk.
Interested in a weapon? There's a tale behind every item I've got.
Oh my god. It's a completely different different shop.
What are you peddling?
Completely different shop from the other guy. Wow. Okay. Well, nothing that I want to sell. Or buy, sorry. Or sell. And yeah, let's give him the bad news. Shall we play cards with him before we give him the bad news, or play, or give him the bad news and play cards? Yeah, what we'll do is we'll give him the bad news first, and then when he's upset and down, then he won't be at the best of his Gwent playing ability, and we'll pounce and kick a man while he's grieving. Excellent.
Think I have something that was meant for you.
A letter from me mum. Says here me sis was bringing it. How'd you come by it?
Yeah.
Came across some bodies in the woods, victims of a monster attack. Found this letter on one of the dead, a woman.
Singer's dead. Ah. Told her and mom so many times. Come over, live with me. No, I had to stay on Pharaoh. I gotta send someone to fetch her body.
I'm sorry.
Thanks for bringing word. Not every man will go to the trouble. Here, take this.
But before you do...
Leave me to the grief.
No!
Leave me to the grief.
Not looking pretty.
Go.
Oh. We can't kick him while he's down, damn it! He's too grief-stricken to play Gwent. Oh. Maybe it's a blessing in disguise. I mean, how low can you get? Trying to beat a grieving man at a game of cards. What have I become? Right, Kraken Crate, where are you? You're not grieving, are you? Oh, he's in his castle, somewhere. How are things after the old bloodbath with the berserkers? Everything back to normal, or as near as can be?
Jeepers, you a wraith from Moorhole?
Yeah, not too bad. Not too bad. Although, why are you dancing to no music? It looks just weird.
They smear your ass with honey, yet hero.
Well, just go help ourselves, shall we? Hello, morning. Morning, everyone. Don't mind me. I'm just going to go and see Mr. Ancrate. Ah! Greetings.
Telling you, Geralt, since you and Hjalmar defeated the Ice Giant together, I see you as one of our own.
I got the look of a Skelliger.
You've got the heart of an Ancrate.
Ah, okay.
Your daughter, first woman to rule Skellige.
She'll be a good queen, knows what she wants.
Yeah, so what does she want?
To unite all of Skellige's clans. A difficult task, no one has ever managed it. But Ceres is stubborn.
Thinking long term then. Think she'll succeed?
She's got a powerful ally. In me.
The massacre during the feast. Know anything new?
Thanks to you and Ceres, we know who's responsible. It's enough for me.
Not gonna try to capture the berserkers?
They were but tools, Wolf. I'd rather sever the hand that wields the sword than merely break steel.
What's new in Skellige?
Of late, look seaward and you'll see their son on a sail, staring right back. We've yet to capture any of their crew, but only a fool wouldn't know they're planning something.
And finally...
You ever play Gwent?
Ha! Ermion taught me the rules and gave me a deck. Wish to play?
Yes.
Let's play a quick round.
Very quick though. I'm a very busy man. You know, can't be sitting around all day drinking with druids, you know, and playing cards here, there, and everywhere. Even trying to beat a grieving man. Just joke. I didn't try to beat a grieving man. No. Right. Change that one. Ah, yes. Oh, look at that. Tight bond combination maneuver. That's going to be deadly. 215 point. Special cards. Villain Chuttonmurth. Yennefer. Oh, yes. This is looking like a good draw to me. I'm going to risk Vesemir, actually. And get another siege. Oh my god, this could be hellacious. And if he's playing two pointers already, well, things are looking good. Mr. Ancrate, I hope you're ready for a beating. A royal beating. A royal beating. Oh, don't worry, that's not a problem. Now you can play your muster cards if you want. You don't want to? Okay. Still not playing any of his muster cards. Alrighty. I don't really want to use any more of my siege. And it's too early to play this, because you might have clear weather, and then it's going to be a waste. Nothing to use Yennefer with. Villain Tretemurth, I could take off 6 points, but I could take off a hell of a lot more if I time it better. To be quite honest with you, these two, tight bonded with Fall Test, is going to be strong enough without the need of every single siege piece. So I'll use another 6-pointer for now. He's got 4 cards left. I have to win this round. I cannot afford to lose this round, so I'm going to have to go for it. I'll use another one of these. Is he gonna pass? No, he's gonna use a 10 point long range hero card. Okay, right, and I'm gonna have to use Villain Tretemurth. I can't really not use it at this point. Although if I could save that for the next round actually and use this instead. He's passed. Obviously doesn't have a clear weather, I don't think. Either you had a bad draw, Mr. Ancrate, or you're saving all your musters for now. Because your deck's not impressed, I have to say. No, still. There's just no synergy to it, is there? Wow, his deck was rubbish. Easiest game of the day, and I have to admit I thought this was going to be the toughest one.
You're good. Know what, Wolf? I've this rare card here. Take it. It'll be of more use to you.
Thanks.
You might consider challenging a man in Kaer Trolde village. A worthy adversary, though a mere tailor.
Oh!
Shuster's his name.
Shuster, you say? Shuster, the man who trims my beard? Well, it is getting a little bit out of hand, so kill two birds with one stone, eh? Game of Gwent with Shuster, and then maybe play whilst he's trimming my beard. Multitask. See how good he really is.